There are a few questions I'm asked on a semi-regular basis that stump me more than, what kind of music do you listen to? It's a question I feel like I should be able to answer on the spot, but I hope I'm not alone in finding it a difficult thing to respond to. It's even more frustrating because I have the answer right in front of me. I can open Spotify now, and thanks to the clever strategy I've co-opted of sticking everything into one giant playlist, I can see all of the music I listen to. That isn't particularly concise, though. I could craft a little highlight reel of my favourite songs, but then that's subject to my own internal biases. I'll probably only include what I think is the most socially presentable music. Besides which, I think when people ask you the question, they're expecting a level of diversity in your song selection. What I really want is some objective third party to tell me what kind of music I listen to. Computers are a good objective third party. I've covered music plenty of times before, and I've covered computer science too. Today we're doing the previously unheard of double feature. I want to end up with a program that gives me a representative, but crucially diverse, sample of the music I listen to. To get there though, I think we first need to figure out what makes one song distinct from another. Things that spring to mind are genre, artist, mood, instrumentation. Decent start, although how exactly do you quantify a song's mood? Well, you don't. Spotify does it for you. Beyond the surface level information you see when you're using the app, Spotify holds a load of secret data about its catalogue of music. Luckily for us, we can use Spotify's API to grab all of this info, given a song. So let's discuss, in no particular order, the top 13 stats that Spotify doesn't want you to know about. And in doing so, we'll hopefully discover what makes a song unique, or at least what I think makes a song unique. Number 1, danceability, which describes how suitable a track is for dancing. You'll find that most of these stats are on a 0 to 1 scale, where a 1 either represents this song has this property to the max, or it's highly probable that this song has this property. An example of a danceable track is Stuck in the Middle with You by Steeler's Wheel. It's got a strong beat and a fairly quick tempo. Number 2, instrumentalness, which predicts whether a track contains no vocals. Whether or not a song is fully instrumental is a pretty good marker, I think, of its genre. So this one's worth considering. Number 3, acousticness, a confidence measure from 0 to 1 of whether the track is acoustic. I found this to be one of the less accurate stats. I still think it's worth some consideration though. Number 4, key, the key the track is in, obviously. In the grand scheme of things that make songs sound unique, I feel that key is fairly irrelevant, so we can move on from this one. Number 5, energy, a measure from 0 to 1 that represents a perceptual measure of intensity and activity. An example of an energetic song is September by Earth, Wind & Fire, which makes sense, it's fast and it's frantic. Number 6, duration MS, which is unsurprisingly the duration of the track in milliseconds. Really long songs and really short songs are certainly noteworthy, but aside from those extremes, I don't feel that length really plays into the X factor of a song. Number 7, valence, a measure from 0 to 1 describing the musical positiveness conveyed by a track. I think this one's my favourite because it's a lot less clear how it might be derived, and it's something I've thought about in the past. Classic happy song Mr. Blue Sky only gets a rating of 0.478 though, which is shocking to me. Number 8, liveness, which detects the presence of an audience in the recording. For our purposes, I think we can ditch this. Number 9, tempo, the overall estimated tempo of a track in beats per minute. Tempo already influences a few of the other audio features I've mentioned, which probably justifies it as a fairly important property of a song. Number 10, loudness, the overall loudness of a track in decibels. This one doesn't really give us much of an insight into the uniqueness of a song, and it can vary significantly between releases of the same song, so good riddance. Number 11, mode, the modality, major or minor, of a track. It's a big generalization to say that this indicates whether a song is happy or sad, and I'll probably annoy a few musically inclined people in doing so, but for the most part it is true. Number 12, time signature. This is an estimation of the time signature of a track. The vast majority of the time this is going to be 4-4, so when a song is in an unconventional time signature, it's usually pretty noticeable. Hence, I think we should consider it. Lastly, number 13, speechiness, which detects the presence of spoken words on a track. Most music falls on the lower end of the scale, with rap tending to sit somewhere in the middle. Speechiness is sort of a counterpart to instrumentalness, though still an important property to include, I think. And there you have it. I try to arrange these in a rough order of importance, and what I came up with is on the screen. I'm sure you'd rank them differently, but hopefully this doesn't seem too absurd. The next order of business then is, how do we use this data? What we want to do is, given a load of songs, use the information we have at our disposal to partition them into groups of similar-ish songs. We can then pick a single representative from each group to form a new playlist. I deliberated over how many groups to split the tracks into for some time, until the name Seven Deadly Songs came to me in a dream, not unlike I imagine how Yesterday came to Paul McCartney. They'll both be equally successful ideas, I'm sure. If you're interested in the specifics, I used Python and Spotify to do this. I used k-means clustering. To initialize the seven centroids, the program just randomly shuffles the playlist it's given and picks the first seven elements. As such, results will vary. The algorithm iterates 100 times, a number just as arbitrary as 7. To calculate this similarity between tracks, I used Euclidean distance, giving a heavier weighting to the properties I deemed most important. The script I ended up writing doesn't actually explicitly factor in genre. Spotify attaches genre to artists rather than songs, so I originally had it factor in artists when calculating the dissimilarity between songs. Counterintuitively though, this seemed to make the final selection less diverse, so I scrapped that, although it still tries to pick as many different artists as possible. I also decided to throw release year into the mix because I deemed it too important to omit. Having done all this, I can now finally answer the question that started this off. What kind of music do you listen to? Well, I'm glad you asked. Here are my seven deadly songs. Come and Get Your Love, Dancing in the Moonlight, Goodbye Yellow Brick Road, Magic, Isn't She Lovely, My Sweet Lord, Let It Be. Now, at the start of this video, I made a point of wanting an objective third party. Is this truly objective? No. Any program inherits the biases of the person who writes it, and I've somewhat arbitrarily decided which properties of a song are most important. Also, music is art. There's plenty of maths to be found in music, but at the end of the day, there's a limit to how much you can quantify it and categorize it. All of that said, I'm pretty content with the result. You can find my code linked in the description if you want to try this out on your own playlist. It might take some time if you've got a lot of songs, but it should, fingers crossed, work. If you're only interested in checking out your song stats, I found this tool, again linked in the description, that lets you do just that. Thank you very much for watching.